Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use delay effects. A delay effect simply creates a duplicated signal that plays shortly after the original signal. It gives an echo effect that diminishes each time it repeats. We'll cover how best to use this effect, some of the controls, and some situations you want to avoid when mixing. Delay is a fantastic effect to use to make a track more interesting. It is typically very quiet and subtle, but would surely be missed if it were removed. We like to use a delay on tracks such as vocals and guitar, but we don't find it very effective on rhythm instruments like drums and bass, since they require a solid beat, and inconsistencies caused by the delay effect could cause a very confusing and uneasy sound. With our delay, we have a few options to control the type of sound we get from the delay. We are able to switch between tape, tube, and analog delay. By our observations, we've found that the tape delay is the softest, the tube creates a small amount of gritty distortion, and the analog delay has a very clean and exact reproduction of the signal in the delayed signal. Our next set of controls determine the level of the original dry signal and the wet reproduced delay signal. We generally like to keep the dry signal turned up high. We don't always recommend leaving it at 100% since the addition of the wet signal may leave the resulting track at a higher level than it was before. The wet signal is a sound that has gone through the delay and has been played back after the original signal. We recommend setting the wet signal lower than the original so it sounds like it's fading off and there's no extra confusion added to the beat of the song. You can also get a very interesting sound if you set the wet signal louder than the dry signal. The first strike of the note will be very quiet, followed by a louder delayed signal. This next control is common to every delay effect you'll use. It sets how long the delay is before the wet signal is played. There is no set time you'll want for this, and it really depends on the time between notes. It will need a little adjusting to be sure that it doesn't sound too fast or too slow. We usually like to set the delay to around halfway between the two notes, but this depends on your preference. In some cases, you may want the delay to repeat multiple times. The feedback control allows the wet signal to go back through the delay effect and it decays slightly each time. By adjusting the feedback, we can control how many repeats we get. Keep in mind that turning this control too high will result in a complete feedback loop, similar to a microphone being placed too close to a speaker. When the delayed signal is added, it isn't always exactly the same as the original. There's typically some distortion that's added as well. This can actually be a good thing, and it's part of what sets apart the tape, tube, and analog delay settings we looked at earlier. As the track increases, the distortion increases, and the differences between the three modes become more apparent. Since we talked about how the tube delay creates a bit of a gritty sound, we'll use that as our example since it will have the most noticeable effect. The last control adjusts the stereo spread and allows the delay to spread from left to right. Most times with a delay, as in this case, you'll be working with a mono signal, so this won't make a difference. Thanks for watching this video on working with delay effects. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel and give us a like. You can also check out our other videos on Audacity and audio effects you should know to record. To keep up to date on all our new content, you can like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Links to our social media accounts can be found in the video description.